Today, we are going to discuss this circuit collector to base bias. Okay, and what about the circuit diagram? This is a common emitter configuration of NPN transistor. Emitter is grounded. This is a base terminal. The input signal is given to the base through capacitor. VCC supply is here. This is a VCC supply. The RC resistor is attached to the collector. Now, collector to base, a feedback path is provided here. A feedback path is, there is a feedback path between collector and base because of the RB resistance. RB resistor provides a feedback path collector to the base side. Okay, the total current through VCC is IC plus IB. IC plus IB started from VCC, so it passes through RC and reaching it here, it is splitted. Only IB pass further through RB and IC get through the transistor. And IB is flowing like along this direction. A voltage develops between base and emitter, that is called VBE, and a voltage is developed between collector and emitter, that is called VCE, collector emitter voltage. Okay, and this is DC biasing with voltage feedback circuit, because this is the output side. Output is taken at here, so the output, a part of the output is connected to the input, and it is called feedback, and this is voltage feedback. The collector to base bias circuit is also called voltage feedback circuit. So this circuit is an improvement over this circuit, fixed bias circuit. In this, biasing resistor is connected between collector and base, but in case of fixed bias circuit, there was a VCC supply and two resistors were connected, RC to the collector and RB to the base independently. Okay, and this circuit is modification of the fixed bias, that disconnecting the connection from here, and this lead is then from here, it is connected directly to this point, and that becomes collector to base bias circuit. Now let we study the mathematics. Okay, now in case of fixed bias circuit, the voltage at here, which is VCC, a part of the voltage is developed across RB. It is by Ohm's law IB into RB, and rest of the voltage, remember we are writing Kirchhoff voltage law along this path. Rest of the voltage appears across base and emitter of this NPN transistor, and voltage across base and emitter, it is VBE. And if you find the value of IB from here, IB becomes VCC minus VBE divided by RB. So IB, it is in case of fixed bias circuit. Now similarly, if we apply Kirchhoff voltage law along this path to collector to base bias circuit, the VCC voltage,
a part of the voltage develops across RC. It is IC plus IB, bracket close, into RC plus voltage developed across RB. It is IB into RB plus voltage across base and emitter, VBE. Now you just we are interested for IB here, so VCC becomes IC RC plus IB RB plus IB RC plus IB RB plus VBE. So VCC becomes IC RC plus IB is taken as common. It is RB plus RC plus VBE. Okay, and VCC becomes, and we are interested for IB now. Now you know that the beta current gain, common emitter configuration, it is IC upon IB, and IC becomes beta times IB. Substituting the value of IC here, VCC becomes beta times IB into RC plus IB RB plus RC plus VBE. Now IB is taken as common again. IB is taken as common. Now here beta RC plus RC plus RB plus VBE. Now VCC becomes IB, beta RC is taken as common, beta plus 1 plus RB plus VBE. Now IB maybe can be calculated from here. IB collected to base bias, it comes VCC minus VBE upon RB plus RC into beta plus 1. Now you just compare this IB, which is collected, which is calculated from collector to base bias, with IB, which was in the case of fixed bias, fixed base bias. Fixed base biasing, this was IB. Collector to base bias, this is now IB. What the difference? VCC is the same, VBE, this is also the same, RB is the same. So this is the additional factor which is appearing in case of collector to base bias. Remember. Now we are writing Kirchhoff law along this direction to collector to base by circuit. Now the voltage VCC is equals to writing Kirchhoff voltage law, a part of the voltage develops across here, writing Ohm's law, IC plus IB, bracket close, into RC, and rest of the voltage appear between this point and this point, which is VCE. Now let me find the value of VCE. VCE becomes VCC minus IC plus IB into RC. This is the output equation for collector to emitter voltage. Now if there is by chance change in beta due to piece to piece variation between the transistor, and beta may change because of ICO mean the leakage current. Due to change in temperature, ICO changes. So with the result, if IC with the change in temperature, there is an effect on ICO, and there is an increase in ICO, and it will result an increase in collector current. So collector current tends to increase. As a result, voltage drop across RC increases. Well, here the voltage drop will increase, okay? And due to the, and if the voltage drop, this voltage drop increases, then it will affect on the VCE. So there is a reduction. If this will increase, this will reduce VCE. Due to the reduction in VCE, and reduction in VCE implies IB to reduce, and this is the result. And if IB reduces, okay, this results is that the circuit tends to maintain a stable value of the collector current and keeping the Q point fixed. Okay, like if IB reduces, you know this factor will reduce, and it will again get the value, the original value. So the Q point fixed, with the result, with the compensation, Q point will be fixed. So in this circuit, RB appears directly across input and output. Okay, RB is appearing in the input side as well as in the output side. A part of the output is feedback to the input. And increase in collector current decreases the base current. This is important. Increase in collector current decreases the base current, because increase in collector current means this factor will increase and hence reduces this factor. Decrease the base current. So negative feedback exists in the circuit. It is also called voltage feedback bias circuit.